Merry Christmas, happy holiday.
Happy December 12th. It's Tuesday. I finally feel like I got a really good solid night of sleep in after a busy weekend. Yesterday I had my last day of teaching and it went so well. It was really, really fun to teach adults embroidery, and I really hope I can continue the journey of teaching adults embroidery. And I just was reached out to by a quilting store that they might be interested in having someone teach there. So I have to call them today and hopefully something like that will work out. I just signed up for a test knit, which I'm really excited about. I'm a little intimidated, but I think it's gonna be great. I have some beautiful Catskill Merino in a sport weight, and the pattern calls for a DK, but they're very close. So I'm gonna swatch and see if I can get gauge or close to, and what I'll probably do is just bump up my sizing. And I'm checking with the designer to see what she thinks. So if not, I'm probably going to go with something like Cascade 220 from my local yarn store. So we'll see. I don't have that much DK in my stash, and that's one thing I've realized. So I need to start thinking about that when I buy yarn. I buy a lot of fingering weight. One's game wonders. I just finished this really fun hat. It's so wild. This is from Loopy Mango Yarn, and I bought this yarn at Rhinebeck, and I've waited 2 years to make the hat. And I always knew it was gonna be like a really quick knit if I just sat down and did it. But I've learned a lot from this, which is I hate using bulky yarns. It just is so hard on my hands. Like, I can definitely do like a thicker yarn, like some of these yarns I've been getting in my advent calendar, but this like very extra bulky is just really hard on my hands. I love the look of the yarn, but I don't know if I love the process of doing it. So the hat's really soft and it feels amazing. It's not itchy at all. I was like, does it need a pom-pom? But I feel like it's got enough going on. I have a really small head, so it's kind of like extra snug. But yeah, I'm excited I finished this because I told myself it'd be great to have for this winter, just like not wait another winter to get it done. So felt good to finish something since all my projects are pretty intense. I haven't been doing podcasts because I'm doing Vlogmas every day. So it's nice to like have like the everyday check-ins to kind of like touch bases to where I am with my projects. I just finished the second color of the beautiful trifle wrap, and I'm really happy with the way this is looking. I just added in the third color, which is going to be this really pretty yellow from Emma's. Some of them I'm using like advent skeins that I have. Thus far I've been using things that aren't advent just to kind of get the color scheme figured out, and then I'll throw in like the advent skeins from previous year into it. So you can see that's what's gonna be next. I think it's really pretty. I think it's like a surprising color to put in there, and that's what I kind of like to do. But still being soft, I want this to be like a really soft, wintry, pastel-y vibe. Okay, I'm so excited because I get to open stuff now. Let's open. This yarn was like interesting. It was a lot smaller than some of the other packages, so it intrigued me. Like, what will it be? Again, this is Sweet Nesting's Advent Calendar. Oh, that's cool. So different. It's funky. Like, is it cotton? Wow, okay. So it's a very, I mean, this is a textured advent calendar. It's definitely got some texture. It's a cotton, I believe. Very pretty. It's like a soft blue with some white. It almost looks like snow, but it's very hard on your hands. So I'm wondering, like, it's gotta be cotton. I really like this one. It's different. I mean, these are always surprising to open. You really don't know what you're going to get ever. Like, every day is completely different, which is super cool. I think this is gonna make such a neat blanket. I was even thinking like another anthology throw, but I just don't really want to do that again. I loved the anthology throw, but why knit the same thing again when you can knit something new? So yeah, these are really cool when you see them all together. I'm very happy with this purchase. I think it's like definitely different to do a textured yarn advent calendar. So let's see what we get for day 12 of Mermaid's Pearl. Making an interesting sound. This is going to be a Notion because yesterday we got that really pretty yarn. Oh, that's really cool. Oh my God. Wow. It's like an iridescent. It's very shiny, but you can see the Mermaid's Pearl logo at the top. I think this is the Katrinkle. Yeah, this is the Katrinkle's item. So it seems like you can do inches on one side and centimeters on the other. So just like a really small ruler. And it's really cute because it can clip on your bag. It's also just really pretty. So I'm excited about this. It's different. Wow, it's so shiny. Awesome. So today is a busy, busy day. I want to start the test knit if the yarn I have is good. I want to work on my weaving more and maybe some sewing. It might be ambitious. There's just a lot going on. I'm kind of caught up on orders for my embroidery business. I need to consider getting some of the sewing done though. Like, I need to start taking seriously the fact that by next summer I need to have more merchandise. So this is my time to really hunker down and embroider. So I'll probably work on some of that too. My dad's getting his hip replaced tomorrow, so I'll be going to Boyne City, Michigan, where my parents live, like probably on Thursday or so, so I can like be there for him and my mom and help them out. So I have a lot of like packing to think about because I'll probably come back here like once before Christmas just for a teaching opportunity. But other than that, I need to like have everything packed up and organized. And I'm excited to spend time with my family over the holidays. Like, we do so much baking. I have this like Olympics games like planned out. So I have a few games. I need to do more research on that. I just know that if I don't start thinking about these things, it's all gonna start to build up on me. So better to cast on the test knit so that way I don't, like, I have a little bit of leeway on it and I know what I'm getting myself into. I think sometimes it's just like starting to understand the pattern, and I haven't worked from charts that much, and this is pretty chart heavy pattern. But the one time I did use a chart, I thought it worked really well for the way my brain works. So yeah, that will be good. I hope everyone has a really great rest of your day. It's the 12th day of Christmas, as they say, so we're really getting close to the holidays. So all right, talk soon. Bye.
Happy holidays.
Merry Christmas.